Good morning. Welcome to Dharma Yoga. And thank you for joining. We'll be starting in the boat very, very, very soon. Namaste. Just remain established in stillness and reverence. Nothing to do, nothing to seek. Everything we need can already be found within. Let's begin with the sound of Om three times to bring divine attention to the self. Imagine you are everywhere. Fix your mind in God alone. The mantra Om Namah Shivaya, which means I bow to the inner light. Calm response. beings everywhere be happy and free from suffering, and enjoy this practice through our senses and be nourished through our bodies. So let's come to standing and begin the practice, the physical practice. So we'll start with the feet 10 inches apart. We'll start with a visualization type of breath. This is called charge breathing. So imagine you're drawing the Earth's energy up all the way up through the body, and then we'll feel the body, we'll have the energy of the Earth to bring us into a deeper state, into a more energized state. So the hands are straight up, palms facing in. As I count to eight, you're breathing in from the soles of your feet all the way up to the fingertips. Visualize the energy moving up, holding the breath and the attention at the fingertips for a count to six. On the exhale, the breath goes all the way back down the same path to the ground. Feel the whole body fully charged. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold the energy and the breath at the fingertips. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale all the way back down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale, feel as though the energy were rising all the way up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The attention and the breath retention at the fingertips. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale all the way back down. Feel the body being charged as the breath moves down. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Last time. Inhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Holding at the fingertips. 5, 6. Down. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bring the arms down now, and let's continue with the exercises. We'll start to move the head in circles. Loosen the neck so that the head can move freely. Feel as though the head were very heavy. Ears trying to touch the shoulders, but the shoulders stay down. Chin touching the chest, the back of the head touching the top of the back. And then switch the direction of rotation. Move according to your condition. If you'd rather do half circles, then go with what your body feels is appropriate. Shoulder rolls now, rolling the shoulders backwards. Feeling the movement of the shoulder blades coming together and separating. Then amplify the effect by bringing the arms into the movements. Imagine the shoulder blades as the wings of the heart. Exercise them. And then roll forward, just the shoulders to begin. And then start to bring the arms into the movement now. Release. So left arm up, inhale, exhale to the right arm up, exhale to left. Just continue. Energize the body, oxygenate the blood with a vigorous breathing. Strong inhales, strong exhales. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, come into squat. If you can't come all the way down, don't worry about it. Just come to the level that you can. Reach up, inhale, and down. And come back up. Elbows out to the side. Twist from side to side. Exhale as you complete the twist. On each side. And release. Shake.
Shake out the fingers, the wrists completely loose, then up and down as fast as you can. Good. Out from here, inhale the arms up, roll the body down, the exhale. Last one, just stay down. Allow the body to stop shaking. Good. And then just bring your hands down onto the ground, come onto your hands and knees. So cat cow, inhale, arch the back, exhale, round the back. Fire up the muscles of the core, inhale, exhale. Stretch the belly skin on the inhale. As you arch the back, exhale, stretch the back skin. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, push the belly and the chest forward and down. Exhale, pull them right back up and in to the body. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good. And then come back on to your hands and feet, coming to downward facing dog. From here, just bounce, trying to get your chest closer to the ground. Allow the shoulders to just, the arms to just keep lengthening, but just relax the shoulders. Allow the head to come down, shake up the head so that the neck is nice and loose. Head dangling. And from here, lift up the heels, walk your feet to the hands, and then slowly roll your way up. And come to the top of the mat. Bring the hands to get the heart to do Surya Namaskar, sun salutations, to continue to open up the back of the body, the spine, and the front of the body as well. So start, first of all, by setting an intention of offering up the practice. Imagine this as a divine duty to all beings. Imagine that all the benefits that we derive from the practice are being extended to every being everywhere throughout the universe. So let's keep that in mind. Let's move together in the same rhythm to stay in that collective mind. Reach the arms up over the head, pull down over the legs. Hands to the ground, bend your knees as much as you need to bring your hands flat on the ground. Then the right foot steps back, lower the knee down, drop the seat down right low. Come into high plank, feet together, lower the knees, chest and chin down. Turn the fingers out a little bit so the elbows come close to the body. And push with your hands, glide your way through between your arms into cobra. Roll over the toes back into downward facing dog. Lift the seat up and back. Then step the right foot forward to the hands. If you need to, lower your knee. Use the right hand to assist the foot forward if it doesn't come all the way forward. Uttanasana, bring the chest to the thighs and the feet together. Come all the way up. Hands back to the heart. Don't worry about the breath, just move in a way that keeps the breathing nice and steady in a uniform rhythm. Left foot back, knee down. Come to high plank. Lower down, knees, chest, and chin. Glide forward. And take it back. Try to make the movements nice and smooth, the transition seamless. Left foot steps forward to the hands. Sink the hip. Uttanasana. Again, you can bend your knees as much as you need to. Bring your chest on your thighs. Come all the way up to standing. Hands bent to the heart. Watch the body moving. In your imagination, watch it moving with much gracefulness and power. Right foot back. And then the body will try to live up to what it sees. Lower down, knees, chest, and chin. Glide forward. It will, especially if you keep the intention of offering the best of the best experience possible to all. Right foot steps to the hands. Left foot joins. Press the body to the legs, head down. Come up. Hands back to the heart. Reach up. Go down. Lose yourself in the sensations. Left foot back. Be like the witness, watching the body moving, knees, chest, and chin down. Watching the mind activity and the emotions without any judgments. any concern as to what it's doing. Left foot forward. Uttanasana, feet together, bowing down. Come up. Hands back to the heart. Reach up. Embody humility in all your actions. Right foot back into the plank. Lower down. Surrender to the highest self. Imagine the highest self delivering all those benefits. It's the common thread that ties us all together to all beings. Right foot steps. Left foot joins Uttanasana. Come up. Return home. Other side. Go down. Left foot back. Keep trying to stay in the same rhythm so as not to excite the mind or bring into state of anxiety. Left foot forward. And feet together. Come up. Hands back to the heart. Let's try one more round. Reach up and back. Explore your range of motion if you're starting to feel warmer now. The muscles starting to loosen up. Right foot back. And then together. Glide. Imagine each pose, each transition. Each pose as an experience. Each transition. You pass through the experiences without changing the mindset from its calm state. Hands back to the heart. Left side. Everything is perfect. Everything delivers us some experience and knowledge to help us eventually remove ourselves from suffering. Come forward and back. Left foot steps. Right foot follows. Uttanasana. Come up. Return home. Take a deep breath in here. Exhale, remove all fatigue, all expectations, and all attachments to the results. Release the arms. Fold forward. Bend the knees so you can bring the chest on the thighs. Slide your hands down the backs of the legs and allow your heels to just your fingers to sit underneath the heels. Push the body against the legs, push the calves against the arms, the lower arms, and draw the body in tight to the legs. Be very flexible, maybe your legs straighten all the way, your chest comes further down the knees with each inhale to get more length in the spine. If you can, you can try to bring your forehead to press against the shins. Keep your knees bent again as much as you need to stay connected to your legs. Then bring the hands down, step back into plank, lower down onto the belly. Roll the shoulders back, inhale, lift through the chest. So do a few strengthening back muscles here, pull the chest up, float the hands up off the mat, spread the fingers. Try to keep yourself up, lengthen through the top of the head, chest wide. And then peel the legs up off the mat as well. Point the toes, stay charged. Lower down here, slide your arms forward. This next exercise, you're rocking on our belly. Don't use the hands, use momentum of the legs to throw you up into the air. So we're lifting the legs and we're rocking. One more time. Come down, forehead to the hands, breathe in, breathe out. And don't worry if you don't get that, just do your best. And just always stay lighthearted and light-minded. Bring your hands beside the chest, roll the shoulders back. Press your way up into cobra, or stay in sphinx if you like, by bringing your forearms down onto the ground. Lift the chest, bring the head back towards the seat. Now picture a cobra in your mind, the king of the serpents. And just try to embody its majesty, its strength, its power. Move the hands closer to your hips. Come up higher if you like. Bring the legs together to form the tail of the snake. Downward facing dog. Take the seat up and back. Breathe in. Breathe out. Left foot steps forward to the hands. Place it quietly. Back knee down. Kapyasana. Bring the arms up. Pull the arms up. Shoulders up by the ears. And then drop the shoulders down. Rock them. Shoulders back and forth. Up and down. And try to get to more length of the torso by pulling the, using your arms to pull your torso further up out of the hips. And then see if you can get the arms back a little bit further behind the ears or beside the ears. Keep the arms close to the head so the leg arms stay straight. Kapyasana, crescent moon. Lift through the heart, come back up. Come upright into Sukha Virabhadrasana. Arms out to the side. Stay strong in a pose and steady and steadfast like the warrior. And then down, left hand to the ground, right arm up. Sukha Trikonasana. Stay here if you like, or go into other variations. Perhaps you can take a bind, left arm underneath the leg, drop the shoulder so the left arm can come all the way underneath, right arm over and behind the back, and join the hands beside the seat, not over the seat. It's a little bit more of a reach. Take hold of the left wrist, if you like, with the right hand, and move it up towards the elbow. Pull the right shoulder back. Option here to stay here, including the extended version with your arms extended. Or move weight into the front foot, bend the toes under, lift the right knee up. Move the right hip back, try to get the right leg straight. The head still close to the ground. You can keep your left knee bent if you need to. Keep the shoulder against the knee. Break the pose. Hands down. Turn the head and chest forward. Lower the right knee down. Inhale, come up. Parivrita Parshvakonasana. Bend the toes under. Start with the easy version first. The elbow to the outside of the thigh, left hand to the right hand. Push the left hand to the right. Raise the body up so the center of the chest comes to the thumbs. And then roll the left shoulder back. If you want here, you can extend the arms again. Left arm up, right hand down. If you need something a little bit more softer, you come upright and just stay straight up. Right hand to the outside of the left knee. Left hand to the seat. Push down and push in. Good. From here, I'll demonstrate this way so you can see a little bit better. You can come into revolved triangle. Bend the toes under, lift the back knee, and spin your feet so they're fair, parallel to the toes are facing long edge of the mat. You still continue to press against the outer leg, just close to the knee. You can take a bind here for those who are more flexible. Left arm goes all the way over the back, right arm snakes underneath, and you bind the hands just in front of the belly, close to the left leg. Head down. Move according to your condition. Just try your best. And release. From here, place hands back down on the ground. Turn towards the front again, left foot in front, slide the right foot back, and just move back and forth. Lizard. Once the hips get low enough, you can rest the knee on the ground, press the tops of the feet down, continue to pull the chest forward. If your shoulder is lower than the knee, bring the right forearm down. If it goes well, left forearm can come down as well. And then just continue to telescope the chest forward. If you want, if you can, rest the chest on the ground. Extend through the top of the head. Fix the gaze like a lizard that doesn't blink. Remain still. The more still the body, the more the mind has a chance to come into quietness. Push into the hands, come back up. Bring the seat back. Lift the toes. Inhale, reset the shoulder. Exhale, bow to the front leg. Chest on the thigh. Bend the knee again if you need to, so you can rest your belly on the thigh and your chest. You feel free to stay here or move into Hanumanasana for those who are more flexy. Bend the toes under, bring the seat forward, but just start to slide your heel forward and move your hands back beside your hips so your body's more upright. Now just pull the feet towards one another, press through the base of the toes. Exhale, yield a little bit, go a little bit deeper, sink a little bit more towards the ground. Do this, of course, mindfully. If you're all the way down on the ground, you can bring your arms up, cross the wrists, press the palms together, and reflect complete surrender and devotion. This is what this pose is about. For Hanuman is the embodiment of courage and devotion. Express it. Release, bring the hands back down. If they're up, move into pigeon. So just move the foot back, slide the heel back, and then come onto your left thigh. Just rest the left thigh on the ground. The line of the thigh is in line with the hip, right? Foot moves, scooches back a little bit more. Hips are square. Inhale, lift through the, lift the upper back, lower back up, lift the chest. And then come forward. Bring your hands in front. Keep the left side of the seat anchored down. And go down as you see fit. You can stay higher. Come down as the forearms. Rest your forehead on the fists or all the way down if you like. Again, with your head down, it's the expression of humility and surrender. So try to tap into the consciousness of the pose. And this will eventually allow you to find ease in the pose and steadiness. One more breath, reach out a little bit more, exhale, sink, get heavy through the hips. And coming back. So options here. Just slide your left foot. Bring your left foot back, come into modified side plank. Or you can press into your right hand, left foot, and so you can tuck the right foot underneath. Lots of different expressions of Vasisthana, side plank. Press your hips forward, maybe go into Urdhva Dandasana or partway, it's a wild thing. Slide your left toes back, push into your toes, spin and smear your right hand into the mat. And we can maybe eventually come into release the left arm like this, or bring your hand right down, slide your right foot beside the left foot. Urdhva Dandasana. Let's go where the breath will take you, where the imagination takes you. Let's try your best. And to release, press again into the right hand, keep your hips high. And then return to downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out, soften the heart. And now we're going to move the right foot between the hands. Back knee comes down, flatten out the toe, Kapyasana. Sweep the arms up, join the hands together, or keep them apart so that's easier for the shoulders. And then just again, move from side to side. Move the shoulder joint, loosen the shoulder joints, and then try to get the arms back. Straight arms, think of a crescent moon. Try to imitate the shape. There's no kinks in the line anywhere in the arc from tip to tip. Imagine the index fingers going over the back toe. Come up higher if you need to. Just get extension. and then press into the front knee. Sukha Virabhadrasana, arms out to the side. And then down, Sukha Chikanasana. Right hand down, left arm up. Spinning down so you can see it from the other orientation. Sometimes it helps to see from both sides. From here, if you like, take a bind, drop the right shoulder so that the whole arm can come underneath the leg and bind beside the seat, not over the seat. Left shoulder moves back, open up the chest and the left hip. Feel free to stay here or move into bound triangle. Lean into the front foot a little bit more so you can lift the left knee up off the ground. Lift the left hip. Try to get the left leg straight as the head moves down. Keep the right knee as bent as you need to. Just keep the shoulder with the knee. Good. And release. Bring hands down, hips and shoulders forward, back knee drops down to the ground again. Bend the toes under, left arm up. And then take the elbow to the outside thigh or stay upright if that's the modification that you did the last time. Push the center of the chest towards the thumbs. Exhale, spin a little bit more to the right shoulder back. If you like, you can extend the arms, the right arm up, the left arm, left hand down on the ground. Move the right hip back, head moves forward. Exhale, turn the chest more towards the sky. Feel free to stay here or bring your hands in Anjali Mudra at the heart. Bend the toes under the back foot and lift the knee again. Spin your on your feet, toes facing long edge of the mat. And then keep on trying to get the center of the chest against the thumbs. Take a bind if you like. Right arm over the back, left arm snakes underneath and my hand is in front of the belly. Left hand in front of the belly and the right fingers clasp together the fingers. To move a little bit more weight in so that the weight is even distributed through both legs. Break the pose gracefully. Bring the hands back down. Turn towards the front. Left knee down. Circle right back into Easy Warrior Two. Sukha Virabhadrasana. And then bring the hands down. Hips and shoulders facing forward, move back and forth. And come to your level. You can bring your left, your forearm down if you like, and then the right forearm, or stay on your hands. Rest the knee on the ground, the top of the foot, inhale, project the chest forward, exhale. Keep sinking down weight through the hips and the lower body. You're very flexible. Try to bring your chest right down to the ground. Make sure the knee doesn't fall out to the side. Move the foot out to the side if you need to. One more extension through the inhale. Exhale, sink through the seat. Come back onto the hands. Walk them back, the side, hips, just a little bit back beside the shin, and then lift the toes. Reset the shoulders and bow to the leg. Aldhanamanasana. Bend your right knee if you need to rest your belly on your thigh, or move into full Hanumanasana if that's what you like to do. Bring your seat forward and start to push in your fingertips so you can slide your heel forward. Slide it right off the mat if you need to allow the foot to slide. And then just again, go into the pose mindfully. Pulse without straining the muscles, without overstretching. And once you are ready to come down, if you can come down, go ahead, rest the root on the ground. Bring the arms up over the head, cross the wrists. And pull yourself up nice and tall. Use the props as you need to. You can rest the prop underneath your front leg, underneath the thigh or the shin as you need to. Move according to your condition. perfect the pose. Bring the head down. If you're in Padmanabhasana, pull the foot back. And then come into pigeon pose. So doing it from the front view. Make sure that the thigh is roughly in line with the hip, maybe a little bit to the outside. Hips are square. Inhale, lift up through the chest, extend the left toes back, and come down. Keep the right side of the seat anchored, and then slide forward, keep the spine nice and long. Come down further as you see fit, maybe eventually right down on the ground. Reflect again, humbleness. Surrender to the highest self. This is, after all, an act of devotion. Practice, an expression of unbridled love for all beings. And then start to make your way back. Press into the hands, push up. You just scoot your left knee forward, and then right leg comes back to make it an easier transition into modified plank, side plank, or you can move into other variations. Try to arc the body away from the ground, press the hips forward, make sure you don't collapse into the shoulder. Keep the shoulder, the arm fully extended. If you want, slide the right toes back, push into the toes, flip your hips and chest up to the sky for wild thing, or go even further. You may smear your left hand into the mat so that you can control yourself to go into Urdhva Dhanurasana. It's just an option. And then return. Keep your hips high. Again, keep the strength of the arm nice and strong and extend it as you move back into Downward Facing Dog. Breathe in. Breathe out, soften through the heart. Good. Now come onto the knees for a moment. And then you're going to take the elbows back. You can sit on your, flatten your toes if you like. Take the arms back behind the ears. Push them back behind the ears if you can. Drop the shoulders at the same time. Inhale. Lift them up. Squeeze the elbows towards one another. So you're trying to press them right against one another on the inside. Pull the arms back again, shoulders down. One last time, inhale, come up. Lengthen, draw the body out of the hips. Exhale, pull the arms back. Sink more weight into this. Heels through the seat, shoulders down. Hold it there. Be steady in the pose. And then bring the arms down. So working towards your forearm balance, lots of different options here. You can just keep your arms down. I like to have them a little, sometimes when you're starting, it helps to have the elbows a little bit further out than the fingers. It gives you a little bit more balance sometimes with wider surface area. Look beyond the fingers, walk your feet towards the elbows. And you can just start by just pressing both heels up off the ground and come back down. This is a very good workout for the core. Lift the toes, try to get your seat over the shoulders and back down. If you want, you raise one leg up, keep the foot close to the seat, bend the toes back. So you're pressing through the base of the toes to keep your muscles engaged. And then press off, again, up off the heel, come onto the toes, push into the arms more. Eventually, you push into the arms and you use your knee to push into the belly. Your shoulders, hips will come in the same line, make it easier to push off the toes and eventually come up. Do this mindfully, no big jumps, no fast and aggressive movements. Okay, good. If you can come into there, just try to stay up. Keep your feet close so in case you fall over, your feet are already close to the ground. Come back down. Child's pose. Breathe in. Breathe out. Remove all fatigue. Just imagine yourself going into the pose with complete ease and effortlessness.
practice, eventually, perhaps it will come.
So we're going to come up again into downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out.
A little bit of sequence of a balancing poses. Slide your left foot forward, halfway to the hands. Come into finger stand, both hands. So stay, keep the left hand grounded, raise your right leg up, and open up to the side, to the right side. Open up the right hip, chest facing up, and perhaps you can take the right arm up into Adho Chandrasana.
Those you want, you can bind the foot. Use a prop again if you need to. If your body's all hunched down and it's difficult, you can bring a block underneath the hand to make it easier. If you want to hold the foot, you hold the foot and pull it away from the body. Open up. Stretch from the shoulder to the knee. Nice long line. Next progression. Bend the standing leg a little bit. Stay heavy on the foot. See if you can come up into Nathanavajasana. If you like. Once you're up, take the shape of the pose. Keep visualizing in your mind and keep looking. Imagine your body. Just try to copy what you see in your mind. Keep your chest high, your lines nice and smooth. Come back down. You can release the foot if you need to. Come down gracefully if you need to. Bend the standing leg and release. Come back into downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Take a moment to just visualize yourself moving through the transitions effortlessly. See if the body will obey. On the other side. Right foot comes halfway to the hands between the feet. Come again onto your fingertips so that you have more height. Push firmly into the fingertips. Raise the left leg. Then open up the hip. As the hip opens, keep pressing down through the right fingertips and the right foot. Open up to the side. Adho Chandrasana. Left arm floats up. Feel free to stay here. Or bend the knee, take the foot in a bind, and pull the foot away from the body. This is good for you. You stay here. If you want to go a little bit further, look, chest facing the ground, soften standing leg a little bit, pull the foot towards the seat so you can come up steadily. Into Natarajasana. Engage the muscles below and above the knee, and then you can take whatever form you like in the pose. Be creative, visualize in your mind, and allow the body to execute the best that it can. Come back from the pose, pull foot in, heavy on the front foot, standing foot, so bend the knees, you can bring the hand down. And then the other hand, downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out, soften in every sense of the word. And then come down onto the knees, child's pose. Breathe in, breathe out. Roll your way up to seated. Adho Vajrasana. So if you can, keep your left leg bent. Your foot beside your hip. Don't sit on the foot, the foot's beside the hip. And then take the right leg out from underneath. So if this is uncomfortable for your knee, make sure there's no strain or painful feeling in the knee. You can bring the foot out in front if you need to. So do it this way to show. And then you bring the right knee up to the shoulder, hold the foot, sit upright, pull the body up out of the hips. May stay here or extend the leg. Kranchasana, heron. Now, like a heron that has long lines all the way throughout its body, try to bring that into your posture as well. Sit up tall. Lift the lower back. Bring the foot towards the head without crunching forward to meet it. Stay tall. Remember, you can just stay with your shoulders back and your heel in front of the knee as well. And then from here, keep the knee bent. Some of you might be able to come into lotus. If you lean back and you bring your foot across the body, it comes close to the top of the thigh, then you just slip it into the hip crease. And then knee comes down. So if it doesn't come down, it's a mile away from the ground, you can just place the foot on the ground and bring the heel against the perineum and just press the toes against the knee. If you are in your Bhadravadrasana, your leg would fold back and then the foot comes high up into the hip crease. Take a bind here, move the chest to the right, sweep the right arm around the body, and you might be able to use your other hand to assist the hand to find the foot more easily. Or you press your hand into your hip, or you take a strap and wrap the foot, or you simply grab your shirt. Inhale, lift through the chest. Exhale, turn to the right. Make sure the left side of the seat stays planted down. Sit tall. Press against the outer knee with the left hand and turn more. Look over your back shoulder. Coming back to face forward. Good. So we're going to try something new today. Take the left foot out in front. And then just place your hands beside the seat and you can slip your foot out of the lotus now. If you have the lotus, just kind of slide it out. Have the foot just hanging beyond the edge of the knee. And bring your hand right up beside your heel. Sit up tall. The seat is not on the ground. It's just a little hovering above the heel, just against the seat. So if this is good, you try to bring the right arm up and bring the elbow that's the upper arm against the foot and push the knee out to the right. You can stay here, okay? Just try to stay upright. Push against the foot so the knee comes back a little bit. So feel a twist, look over your left shoulder. Next progression, if you like, come forward, bring your hand down. Keep the foot pressing into the upper arm, close to the shoulder. Come forward, perch yourself on the arms. It's called dragonfly. Then you can extend the leg out. So you want to have your foot close to the shoulder. If it comes too close to the elbow, you'll probably fall off your arm. The foot will fall off the arm. Okay, so everything done in little steps. Okay. All right, so we're going to come back out now. Release. Shake up your legs. First time you see it, it looks a little bit crazy perhaps. The more you do it, the more the mind becomes, adapts to that vision and tries a little move towards the realization of it. Just keep trying. Other leg folds back or keeps in or stay in front. Take the left foot in the hand, push the shoulder into the knee. Stay the back vertical and straight. And if you like, straighten up the leg, push to the base of the toes. So you can get the chest higher as well. You're trying to get the chest higher than the knee. Shoulders back. And from here, lean back so that the foot can come close to where it has to go at the top of the right thigh and slip it in. Try to get the foot as high as possible in the hip crease. So that makes the bind easier. Turn to the left, belly over the left thigh, roll the head of the shoulder forward and bring the arm around. And then I might find the foot a little bit more easier. Hold the foot or again, take your modifications, hand on the thigh or just holding your shirt. Right hand to the outside of the left knee. Inhale, lift through the chest. Exhale, you spin. Make sure the right side of the seat doesn't become dislodged. Keep both sides of the seat rooted and the body straight. sometimes the body ends up looking like this. You want to try to rock back so that the right side seat is planted down. Lift through the chest, go to the left. Keep pressing against the outer knee as you twist to give you a little bit of counter resistance. Come back. If your leg is folded back, bring it out in front, and then come take the foot out of lotus, and then you can just even just perch here. Okay, try to exercise your balance skills. Allow the seat to come off the ground, it's hovering just above the heels. You can stay there, or you can try to bring the left arm up, come on through to, and then see if you can push the back the arm against the foot, and then turn towards the right, push the knee back out to the left. If this is good, you have to kind of crunch a little bit, so make yourself small so that you can get your foot close to the shoulder so that you're in a good position. When you bring your hands down, they're beside each other, you lean forward very much like a crow. You're sitting on your left arm. Extend the leg. You can keep your foot tucked in if it's easier. And back down. Release. Shake out the legs. Inversions. Shield shasana headstand. I'll offer variations and modifications. So if you're very unfamiliar with inversions and you're feeling like you want to keep your feet on the ground, just bring your head in front of your knees, lift your seat, and just keep holding onto your heels. And just try to roll your seat up so that you're on the top of the head. If you're more proficient, you bring your fingertips wide base, way out in front of the head where you can see them, and wide to the edges of the mat. You press into the fingertips because they have a lot of strength. And then you bring your left foot up and back. Keep the foot close to the seat again. Press to the base of the toes. And again, you just bounce, you just get a little bit of buoyancy. Just see if you can press your heel up so your hips come a little bit over the shoulders. Eventually, if you press into your fingertips really hard, quite hard, and you push in the back foot, base of the toes, you might be able to come up again. Do this mindfully, nice and slow. No big, heavy, fast jumps, okay? If you're more steady in the pose, you can see if you can eventually take the weight up off the fingers one at a time. Maybe eventually come up right onto the fingernail of one finger. Just move according to your comfort level. If your mind is screaming at you to not go there, listen to it. You have time. Just wait and be patient. Make way to come back slowly. Just try to touch your toes very lightly to the ground. And come back down into child's pose. Roll back. Seat on the heels, forehead to the ground, breathe in, breathe out, relax, roll your way up. Good. So, take your legs out in front, lie on your back. Take a moment in this pose, breathe in. Breathe out all fatigue. Imagine you're fainting. Moving into shoulder stand, the modification is bridge pose. We'll all start there. Bring your arms beside your body, palms down, slide your feet in close to the seat. So you can, if you reach for the, you might be able to touch, you should be able to touch your heels with your fingertips. Then lift your seat up. Move the arms underneath the body, tuck the shoulders under.
And you can interlace the fingers, press into the outside edges of the hands or fingers, lift the chest up. The chest should be close to the chin, it should look like a wall. You can stay here the whole time if you like. The heart is still higher than the head, so it's still an inversion of sorts. Or you can bring your hands to the back with your fingers facing towards the backs of the knees. And try to get your elbows close to one another underneath the body. Lift one leg up, knee comes into the chest, the foot comes beyond the head. And if you keep pushing your weight, your hands into your seat and seat into the hands, you'll be able to get to maybe your other leg up. Come into tuck, stay in a tuck if you like. Or extend your legs, push into the back and try to find a straight line from the chin to the toes. If you have a lotus, you may come into a lotus. Now if you need to come up into shoulder stand in other way, then do so now. If it didn't work for you to come up that way, through bridge. If you want to go into lotus, you may use your hands. Bring your feet a little bit further beyond your head, behind you, so behind the head, so that you can have the balance to move your legs as you need to. Option, if you're right on your shoulders, you might be able to take your hands to the knees or your thighs. Try to push your knees up higher than the hips. You can do this with straight legs as well. Candlestick. Nothing to do. Nowhere to go but deeper within. Close your eyes. Concentrate on the space between the eyebrows. Watch the darkness there behind the forehead. Halasana. Start to bring your feet towards the ground behind the head. If your feet touch down, you can bring your arms behind the back. If they don't touch down, maybe easier and more comfortable to support your back with your hands. You have the option of dropping your thighs against the body and the knees on either side of the head. And go further within, remove all distractions. Block out all the inputs that are coming in through the ears, the sense organs. Close your eyes to shut out the sights as well. Do not be distracted by the senses. Start to make your way out of the pose. Keep the legs close to the body as you roll down. Press the arms heavily into the mat to control your descent so you'll come down with a big, fast, hard landing. Stop when your legs are vertical. And then breathe very fast. Do it through the nose like you're panting through the puppy. Keep that breath going, but lower your legs 45 degrees. Keep going halfway down. Bring the feet down close to the ground, just hovering about 1 inch. Lower the feet down. Breathe in. Breathe that all fatigue, relax. Fish pose. Bring the elbows right beside the body, just against the rib basket. Point the fingers up. Push into the elbows. Push the chest up as high as you can. The head comes up as well. Then bring the head all the way back and rest the tip of the head on the mat. Not too much weight on the head, most on the elbows and the seat. If you feel comfortable here, raise your legs 12 inches off the mat. If you want to go further, flying fish, bring your arms up. And the hands are over the legs together, the arms are parallel to the legs.
Now bust your good breath again. Lower the legs down and the arms, and then roll your way out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Relax. Urdhva Dhanurasana. Slide the feet in close to the seat, edges of the feet in line with the hips. Fingertips beside the ears, facing away from you, equal distance apart. Pull the elbows up towards behind your head. So you open up the armpits and then lift the seat and then slide your head back. Some of you might stay here. That's fine. Turn your hands around, facing the fingers facing the feet, fingers slightly facing out to the outside. And then from here, just push your chest forward, so you're trying to touch the chest to the wall in front of you. If you want, push into the hands and lift the head right up off the mat. Urdhva Dhanurasana. Then play in the pose. Lift the heels if you like. Walk your hands closer to the feet. Try to get your arms and legs straighter. And then just do whatever variations you know if you want to try them. For advanced practitioners, just work on what you feel like. And those who need modification, just stay in bridge pose with your shoulders on the ground. Just like the precursor to shoulder stance. Stay a little bit longer. Practice determination. Eventually the body, if you surrender to the pose, you will find the ease. You forget about the body and the mind goes into state of quietness. And then start to come out of the pose. Walk your hands further away from your feet. Come down slowly, press into your hands so you can come down without landing on your head hard. And then relax in the pose, relax on your back. Breathe in, breathe out. Slide your left foot in, closer to the seat, about halfway, raise your right leg up, take hold of the right ankle. And pull the knee onto the shoulder. And just try to pull the foot towards the head. If this is easy for you, you can extend the left leg, drop the right hip, make sure the right side of the body doesn't get all crinkled up. And you try to bring the foot towards the head. If you're very flexible, you might be able to bring your foot right to the ground beside the head again. Make sure you're not jamming up the right side of the body. Drop the right hip a little bit, roll the right thigh down. Extend to the left heel. Then moving into half happy baby pose. Just allow the knee to slip to the outside of the body, just underneath the arm. So just do it standing. We'll try to do it standing if you can see. So if, imagine I'm lying on the ground. You would look like this. Your knee is on the outside of the body. Your heel is in line with the knee. Vertical. Okay. If you're more flexible, you can try to bring your shoulder in front of the knee and press the hand underneath the seat and use the shoulder to press it down. Push the knee up higher. Eventually, you might be able to pull the leg up, bring your head up off the mat, and you might be able to get your foot behind the head. That's where I fall. Okay, so you just try to, if your left moves, foot moves in closer to the seat, you might be able to get a little bit deeper into the pose. Push the shoulder up into the back knee as high as the knee will go, close to the ear, lift the head, tug on the foot towards the left, and then you might be able to eventually bring your head in front of the foot, and then extend the leg again. All these are more for advanced practitioners if you want to try them. So just go again to the place where it's appropriate for you. Just use your imagination to visualize yourself in a pose. Keep practicing. And then one day perhaps you'll arrive bit by bit. Release the pose. Bring the right leg down, breathe in, breathe out. Remove all fatigue and tension and any emotions that arose or any thoughts, negative thoughts especially, let them all go. Other side, right leg is extended, or the knee, slide the foot in if you need to, and bring the left leg up, take hold of the ankle, knee on the shoulder. Pull on the foot, pull it towards the head, and then remember to drop the left hip a little bit. Use the thumb to roll the hip down. You can extend the right leg as you see fit. You're very flexible. Again, you can try to get your foot beside the head. Keep extending out through the right heel. And then half happy baby pose. Just allow the knee to drop out just beside the body underneath the arm. The heel is over the knee. You're pulling down the foot with your hands. Or if you can, move your left shoulder in front of the knee and push against the back of the knee. Raise it up higher. Try to get the knee close to the ear, the left ear. You can just sit on your hand. Left hand can come underneath the seat if you like, and just stay there. Or you want to try to take your foot behind the head, slide your right foot in if you need to make it easier, lift the head up, tug the foot towards the right. You have to peel the shoulders up off the mat so you can bring the leg up. So you try to get your knee again as high as you can, so it makes it easier. Then you can extend the leg eventually and into deeper expression as you see fit. Okay. Move according to your condition. Respect your limitations. Do what's accessible for you, where you can find steadiness without bringing pain to the body. That's not where you want, what you want to offer to anybody. And break the pose. Bring the left foot down. Relax. Breathe in. Breathe out. Come to C position. Come up any way you like. Good. One last round of back bending. Come onto the belly. Cross the left ankle over the right, hands beside the shoulder, the chest, in the line of the chest, roll the shoulders back, come up into your cobra. If you need to come into sphinx pose, that's perfectly good. And then just gradually push into the hands, let the elbows up the mat to come up the rest of the way. You move your hands in, so move into the pose the way it's appropriate for you. With your feet crossed, it keeps the legs together like the tail, consistent with the form of the snake, which has no feet. Make sure your shoulders are not jammed up by the ears. Keep the neck long. Lower down. Breathe in. Breathe out. Bend the legs up. And push into the hands. You might be able to take hold of the foot, really cross the ankles tightly so you can hook the feet tightly. You can hold one foot and see if you can get your legs up, and then reach the right arm forward. So left arm goes back to hold the foot. If you can, you can try to grab both feet at the same time. So move, keep your feet close to the seat so you can take the bind, lift up into bow pose. This is too much, you can just do regular bow, including keep your thighs on the ground. Again, stay where it's accessible. Okay, or lift your knees up. Lower down, breathe in, breathe out. Right angle over the left. Again, cobra, maybe this time will go easier because you already had one go at it. You can put push braids, your hands would come all the way up if you like, or again, start in Sphinx. And stay in Sphinx as long as you need to, or the whole time. Move in a way that doesn't bring your mind into a place of anxiety and the body into a place of pain. Lowering down, bend the heels up towards the seat, reach back and see if you can take hold of the one foot with the right hand, and then lift up, bring the left arm up, and then see if you can press your ankles where they cross together to lift your legs up. If you can, you have your shoulder mobility, reach back, take hold of the other hand, the other foot, and then lift up into your bow pose, a nice variation, or you just forego the cross and come into your regular bow. Be steady in the pose, make it an offering. One more breath, come up nice and high. Release, breathe in, breathe out. Just turn onto your back. Actually, come seated position. Adamatsyendrasana. So either you keep your left leg, you bring your left leg in front, your left knee sort of set them just in front of the chest on the ground. The right leg comes over. If you find that you can't get the right side to come down, you can just extend your left leg and then bring the foot, right foot further forward towards the ankle. I'll do it this way to show. First, right hand behind the back, right along the center of the seat, right behind the seat. Left arm up and then press the forearm against the knee. Inhale, lift through the chest, push the lower back in using the right arm, supporting you from behind. Turn towards the right. Shoulders in line with the edges, long edges of the mat. Keep the left leg active. If your leg is folded, it would look like this. The left foot beside the right hip. Other variations, you know, go ahead. If you know how to bind or like to do that, by all means. Work according to your level. You've always tried to work at your edge, your comfortable edge, and bit by bit you surpass the edge and you go further and you advance. You make progress. One more breath, rise up tall, and then twist, feeling a twist during the base of this, the hips coming all the way up through the spine until the neck comes in as well. And then release. Try it on the other side. Modify as you see fit. Make sure again you're not sitting on your left foot, your right foot. It's beside the left hip. Foot is beside the knee or closer to the ankle if your right leg is extended. Right arm up and go into the twist. So you can push the knee way beyond the right edge of the body. You're pushing the knee towards the right as you turn to the left. Sit up tall. And before you twist on the exhale. Back, slowly lie on your back for Shavasana. Ease your way down. Don't come down heavily, always moving in a way that doesn't take the mind out of its calm mindset, doesn't distract the mind or jar it, and settle it. Keep the mind ever calm. Once you're on the mat, relax, take deep breaths, gather up all the tension that resides within. Exhale, just let it drop out of the body, leaving a completely limp and heavy feeling. Feel everything just sinking into the ground. Imagine you're just falling into the body's like a dead weight, a ball of lead. And it's just sinking into a bed of clouds or flowers or sand. Feeling the softness cushioning you from underneath and just yielding to that softness. Then allowing that softness just permeate your own body so that it too loses its hardness, its tension, its resistance.
start to bring your awareness back to this space. Start to feel your fingers, your toes. Become aware of the breath. Feel the body starting to awaken. Help it along gently through little soft movements and stretches. And once the body is ready, return it to a seated position, always moving in a way that allows the tranquility that we created to stay intact. Remain reverent, conscious, mindful. And once the body has returned to seat position, sit up tall and straight. We'll do some pranayama in order to prepare for meditation by quieting the mind through this practice. Left hand in Yana Mudra, index fingers touches the fingertips of the thumb. Other three fingers extended, resting on the left knee. The right hand Vishnu Mudra. Second, third, fingers fold down so they never touch the psychic channels in the nose, like go running through the nose. And so we use our right thumb to close off the right nasal passage to control the passage through the breath through the right side, and the right ring finger for the left side. So we're going to breathe in through the left, hold the breath, exhale through the right, inhale back through the right immediately, hold the breath, close both sides of the nose. Exhale to the left. Through the breath retention, both sides of the nose are pinched closed. We bring the chest up, the chin on the chest, tongue behind the teeth to the upper palate, and contract the muscles of the perineum, pull them up towards the navel. Right? So that's through the breath retention, and the count is 4, 16, 8. So we'll count at a fairly fast, steady, pace so that you don't have to, so that if you can't hold your breath that long, don't worry about it. Okay, so you just modify as you need to, but just try to stay with the cue as much as possible. And then eventually you'll learn to you'll get the breath capacity to be able to hold the breath. So you have tall and straight. Bring the right hand up to the nose to prepare. Inhale, exhale completely. Then close off the right side, inhale to the left, 2, 3, 4. Pluck both sides of the nose, hold the breath, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Exhale through the right, release the locks, relax, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale through the left, 2, 3, 4. Hold the breath, I think I counted wrong last time, up to 16, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Breathe out to the left, release the locks. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale to the left. 3, 4. Hold the breath. Attention to the third eye. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Breathe out through the right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale deeply through the right. Got as much of the breath as you can in those four counts and hold the breath for 16. Watch the space between the eyebrows. Throat and root lock. 13, 14, 15, 16. Breathe out through the left. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Inhale left. Fill up completely, then hold the breath, apply the throat in a root lock, third eye focus. 13, 14, 15, 16, breathe out through the right, relax the root and the throat. Inhale through the right, hold the breath. 7, 8,
8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Breathe out to the left. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Continue on your own. Keep the count steady. If you need to modify down, it's too much. 3 on the inhale, 12 on the breath retention, and 6 on the exhale. If the 4, 16, 8 was undoable, was too difficult. You try so that the breath leaves out on the constant stream of exhale, not the big explosion. If you tend to come to that point, then modify the count to 3, 12, 6. That's an indication to drop down to a lower ratio. Keep the back straight. Focus the mind on the space between the eyebrows, the seat of divine perception is what we call it. Count is ever steady and even. After completing the current cycle, do one more. So you start on the left, you end on the left by breathing out through the left nostril. Once you complete it, right hand comes to the right knee in Yana Mudra. Straighten up again. If the body starts to slump forward, be tall and supremely still and erect. Bring your attention to the center of the chest. The spiritual heart, which is located at the right side of the physical heart. Imagine walking right into that heart space, coming face to face with God, as to say your highest self, boundless in its compassion, potential and goodness, and love, loving ability. This is your true nature, love. It's infinite. Imagine the heart space growing infinitely large now. Imagine holding every being in that heart space. And fill that heart space with all your love. All your goodness, all your wisdom. And imagine absorbing all of it from other beings as well. We are all one. We're all connected through that divine spark within our highest self.
close with Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Instill the peace within. Send it out to all beings everywhere. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Be receptive to the divine grace within. Namaste.